Make the effort to go talk to people who are actually in the profession and see what they're like and go help. Because, you know, thinking is really hard, but it's worth the effort. And the worst thing I think that can happen is if you latch on to a certain goal and then you put all your effort into accomplishing that goal, only to find out that after you've accomplished the goal, you didn't really want to accomplish that goal. You know, I used to think early on when I would see friends in college that changed their major, I would think, oh, these people are nuts, and they get their act together, they're changing their major in the middle of college. Now I actually respect those people. They went and they tried something, and they learned they didn't really like it, they changed their major. You're much better off changing your vision, learning about what you want to do early on, than having kind of a blind vision in your mind that maybe is influenced by the fact that I haven't experienced it yet, and maybe it's influenced by somebody on the outside kind of steering in a certain direction. So I just encourage you to try a lot of things. Don't get too set in your ways now. But consciously try to have as many experiences as possible and take notes. I actually did that. I used to take notes about different activities. And you ever heard of Ben Franklin, the pros and the cons? I'd make a decision, and you write the pros of a situation on one side and the cons on the other. You take these experiences, write the pros, the cons, put it all down, and eventually you find yourself going in a certain direction. So I guess I would say that if you try to make sure that you define success in terms that are comfortable for you and not in terms that are comfortable for others. And so, you know, don't become a lawyer because, you know, mom's a lawyer, you know, become a lawyer because you enjoy the intellectual challenge, really understand the details of an issue, put your mind around it, and enjoy the back and forth of arguing for a position, being persuasive. That would be the reason why, not because somebody else is doing it. Don't become a nurse because call a nurse. Become a nurse because you have done enough things and you really enjoy helping people. Maybe you like security, maybe you're not so good for it, you want to solve security. So accept time to learn from your actions. As you go through and you try all these different things, again, sit and take that time to think. I know I keep saying it, it'll be a broken record, but most people don't think. Thinking is hard, and a lot of most people, when it comes to hard to make hard decisions, they just kind of go with easy things, and then they find a reason why they get busy, and they just find a reason not to really think it through. Take some time to think. I want to give a pretty one example, but I actually, when I got out of school, I kind of figured I had this blind vision, I had to have an MBA. I applied to Harvard, I graduated from college, I was doing this business stuff on the side, and so I determined, my friends didn't find me, I actually got out of college for 3 years, I took extra classes, I was like, I was really comfortable, I was going to Harvard, and I tried to get into the MBA, and they looked at me, and I was like, yeah, you know, this is actually a good thing, nobody gets into Harvard MBA, but out of college, I really had one thing to get after, and of course, then I said, well, I don't know, you can go to Michigan, you know, and they didn't get in. A few couple years later, I took some night classes for an MBA. Then I did a couple classes, and as I was taking the classes, I realized, you know, I don't want an MBA. All I want is a business, and I only had a business. So I actually dropped out of the MBA. You know, it would have been a bad move to spend three years in an MBA and not even really want to do it. So, again, think about it.